Okay, so we continue for C everyday English. Do we need a reservation? So in this part, we are going to learn to arrive at and order a meal in a restaurant. ¿Cómo llegar a un restaurante and order a meal, una comida, a meal? And we are also going to learn changing to city and work groups. So the first part, listening. Ask and answer the questions. How often do you go to a restaurant? What kind of restaurant do you like? Do people eat out a lot in your country? ¿Come fuera? Eat out a lot in your country. Okay, now working pairs. Look at picture A. Why do you think the restaurant is empty? Vacío, empty. Choose an answer. The restaurant isn't open. People think the waiter isn't very nice. El mesero, the waiter isn't very nice. Oh, it's very early. Okay, so here we have Annie, Leo, Martina, and Dan. Watch or listen to part one and check your answers in 1B. Okay, so let's check the answers. Wait. Why do you think the restaurant is empty? Because it's very early. Muy pronto, very early. Okay, so now watch or listen to part one again. Are the sentences true or false? And correct the false sentences. Number one, they have a reservation for 4 people. Is it true or false? They want a table by the door. Annie finds it, encuentra, finds it difficult to choose a table. So go back to that part of the video, regresense al video, and answer this, answer this question and correct the false sentences. Once you're finished, una vez que hayan terminado, once you're finished, let's check the answers. Number one is false. They don't have a reservation. Number two, false. They want a table by the window. No by the door, by the window, por la puerta, by the window, por la ventana, o cerca de la ventana. And number three is true. Annie finds it difficult to choose a table. So we're going to check useful language arriving at a restaurant. Read the sentences. Who is the waiter? A or B? ¿Quién es el mesero? A or B? Who's the waiter? Okay, we have no problem. Can we have a table by the window? Good evening. Do you have a reservation? Yes, of course. This way, please. No, we don't. We like a table for 4. The waiter is A. Now put the sentences in 2A in the correct order and listen and check your answers. What do you think is the first? ¿Cuál crees que sea la primera de todas estas? And then you have to put it in the correct order. Okay, listen and check.
Track 2.19. Good evening. Do you have a reservation?
No, we don't. We'd like a table for four.
No problem.
Can we have a table by the window?
Yes, of course. This way.
Okay, now practice the conversation with a partner. Now change what B says into A and use the sentences below. Van a tener que utilizar estas frases para cambiar esta conversación. For example, we'd like a table outside. ¿Por cuál lo podrían cambiar? Exactamente por esta. Can we have a table by the window? Estas oraciones son para pedir la mesa. ¿Dónde les gustaría? By the window, outside, by the door. Ok. And here, number two. Yes, we have a reservation for two people. The name is Merton, but we're 20 minutes late. ¿Por cuál pudieran cambiarla? Ok. For this, no, we don't. We'd like a table for four. Entonces, esta nos ayuda a identificar la reservación. La reservación y para cuántas personas les gustaría la mesa. We'd like a table for four. We have a reservation for two people. Okay, so these are expressions to say how many people you are going to be at the table. ¿Cuántas personas van a estar en la mesa? Okay, so now we continue on listening. Read the restaurant menu. Read what the friends say about food in picture B. What do you think they choose for their main course? We have this picture. Yes, and they say what they like. I really like Asian food. I think I want to eat meat tonight. The only meat I eat is fish or chicken. I love Italian food, but everything on the menu looks good. And here we have the starters and the main course. The starters is the first food they give you. La primera comida que te dan, la primera comida que ordenas. The starter es algo ligero para que puedas iniciar a comer. And we have the main course, el platillo principal. Entonces van a tener que escribir aquí qué es lo que creen que ellos van a elegir for their main course. Martina. This is Martina. I love Italian food. Italian food. What of this is Italian? ¿Qué de esto es italiano? Ok. The only meat I eat is fish or chicken. ¿Esto qué es fish or chicken? I think I want to eat meat tonight. ¿Qué de esto contiene meat? Carne. Now watch or listen to part 2. Which of your answers in 3A are correct? Change the wrong answers. Cambia las respuestas equivocadas. And who can't decide what they want to have? ¿Quién no puede decidir qué es lo que quiere? Ok, Martina, Annie, Dan or Leo.
Are you ready to...
I'm ready.
Fine.
I think so.
What would you like for your stuff?
I'd like the... please.
And for your main course?
I'll have the lamb potatoes.
And for you, what would you like to eat?
For a stuff, I'll have the fish. Chicken salad. And then sounds nice. Can I change my order? I'll have £1 for my main.
And finally, I'm curry. Would you like rice? Yes, and like the fish.
Fish. Best idea. Sorry. Sorry. I'll have to say to Leo.
Fish.
Yes.
You sure about that, honey?
I think so. Yes.
What's
your drink?
Would you like a moment to think about
Okay, so pay attention because they ask the starter, the main course. Ellos piden su entrada y su platillo principal. They ask the starter and the main course. So, wait. Martina asks lamb with roast potatoes. Annie, lamb with roast potatoes. Dan, lamb with roast potatoes. And Leo, Thai chicken curry. Okay? And it's Annie who can't decide what she wants to have. Annie no puede decidir. She can't. Do you sometimes find it difficult to choose at a restaurant? ¿Encuentran difícil elegir un restaurante? Why and why or why not? ¿O hay alguien en su familia que le encuentre difícil elegir en un restaurante? ¿Y ustedes cuánto tiempo tardan en decidir? Okay. Now let's check. Useful language. Ordering a meal in a restaurant. Complete the conversations from part 2 with the words in the box. Okay. So, this is part of the conversation. So, you need to complete it with these words. Let's check. Once you're finished, let's see the answer. Una vez que hayan terminado, once you're finished, let's check the answers. I'd like the mushroom soup, please. As you remember, we don't say I want. No decimos yo quiero, because it's rude in English. We say it, I'd like. And for your main course, I'll have. Recuerden que el have lo utilizamos para comidas y bebidas. Entonces, esa sería también una frase como I'd like, I'll have. En vez de decir yo quiero, decimos I'd like or I'll have para ordenar algo. And here we have, I'll have chicken salad. Then, lamb with roast potatoes. Would you like rice with that? Entonces, aquí el then lo utilizamos para establecer un orden. Si se acuerdan, utilizamos también first, que es lo primero que te van a traer. First and then, que sería lo segundo para establecer un orden. ¿Qué es lo que quieres primero y qué quieres después? First and then. And we use with when we want to say it. Cuando queremos decir que algo va a estar como acompañamiento. Rice with that. Arroz con eso. Ok. Now, tick the two phrases we use when we want to order food in a restaurant. Ok. So, it's I'd like and I'll have. When you're in a restaurant, you can use one of these to say what you want, para decir lo que quieres. I'd like lamb with roast potatoes. I'll have chicken salad. I'll have the lamb with roast potatoes. Okay? Now put the words in the correct order to make sentences. Okay, let's check.
Point 21. 1.
I'd like meat salad for my starter.
2.
I'll have spaghetti for my main course.
3.
I'd like chicken curry with rice.
Okay, so we use I'd like, I'll have, when we want to say it, what we want. Cuando queremos decir que es lo que queremos. Y aquí se está agregando otra palabra. We add 4. Como lo ven, lo ponemos después de la comida. 4. Y decimos en qué momento lo queremos. For my starter. De entrada. For my main course, de platillo principal, ¿ok? También podemos utilizar algo así. I'd like tacos for dinner. En el momento en que lo vas a comer, for dinner. I'd like a milkshake for breakfast. Esto nos está indicando en qué momento se va a estar consumiendo. Aquí en un momento específico de la comida. My starter, my main course. Sin embargo, este nos indica un momento del día. Una comida del día. Breakfast, lunch, brunch, dinner, sopa. ¿Ok? So, here we have the answers. Now, let's check. Pronunciation. Word groups. Listen to the sentences. In each sentence, there are two or more word groups. Write these lines where you hear the start of a new word group. Lo que quieren decir es, por ejemplo, aquí, for my starter, I like raw fish. Word groups es de que hay una pausa para establecer los grupos. Aquí estamos estableciendo en qué momento lo queremos. Y en este, ¿qué estamos estableciendo? ¿Qué es lo que queremos? Entonces, tienen que revisar dónde hay dos o más word groups.
Track point 22. 1.
For my starter, I'd like fish.
2.
And I'll have vegetable pie for my main course.
3.
I'd like chicken salad for my starter.
Okay. So, let's check the answers. And I'll have vegetable pie for my main course. I'd like chicken salad for my starter. ¿Ven cómo se están separando estas dos partes como si fueran dos oraciones? For my starter, I'd like raw fish. Es para dar tiempo para decir lo que quieres y en qué momento lo vas a querer. For my starter, I like raw fish. Now, write the two lines where you hear the start of a new word group. Listen and check.
2.23.
For my starter, I'll have mushroom soup. And then I'd like chicken curry for my main course. And I'll have some rice with my curry.
Okay, we check. For my starter, I'll have mushroom soup. Aquí hay una pausa después del punto. A pause. And then I'd like chicken curry for my main course. And I'll have some rice with my curry. Esto nos ayuda a hacer pausas y también para que el mesero pueda anotar. Ok, in pairs, practice saying the order in 5C. Van a tener que decir esta orden. Ok, now conversation skills. Changing what you say. Look at the two sentences from the conversation, underline the phrases Annie uses when she wants to change what she wants to say. Como pudieron ver en el video, Annie estaba muy indecisa y utilizó dos frases para cambiar lo que quería decir. ¿En qué momento ustedes pueden cambiar lo que quieren decir? Tal vez si están agendando una cita, mencionan un día, pero se acuerdan de que tienen compromiso y dicen, ah, ese día no puedo, entonces puedo otro. El ejemplo que estamos viendo aquí, de que está ordenando algo, se arrepiente y cambia. Entonces, ¿en qué momento ustedes pueden cambiar de opinión sobre algo? Piensen en eso. Ok, y encuentren las dos frases. The phrases Annie uses when she wants to change, cuando quiere cambiar. What she wants to say, lo que quiere decir. Ok. Maybe not. And no, wait. So she uses these phrases to change. For example, what about the one on the right? Maybe not. The one on the left is fine. Aquí lo que está haciendo es cambiar de opinión. The on the right to on the left. And here, I'll have the fish. No, wait. I'll have chicken salad. ¿Qué está haciendo? Cambiando de fish to chicken salad. Now complete the sentences like this and listen and check.
24. 1. I'll have mushroom soup. Maybe not. I'll have chicken salad. 2. I'd like spaghetti, I think. No, wait. I'll have the vegetable pie.
2. I'll have mushroom soup. Maybe not. I like the chicken salad. I like spaghetti. I think. No, wait. I'll have vegetable pie. Now, working groups of 3 or 4, use the menu on page 44, write one more starter and one more main course. Here, you have to add one more starter, tienen que agregar uno, and one more for main course. Now, you are at a restaurant, take turns to be the waiter and the customer. Order a meal from the menu and use phrases from A for A to help you. Practice changing what you say when you order. So, pueden utilizar de aquí frases para pedir and here phrases to change what you want to say. And now you can do unit progress test. Now, let's continue on 4D. Skills for writing. Next, decide on your menu. Learn to write a blog about something you know how to do and making the order clear. We have speaking and listening. Ask and answer the questions. Which of these dishes in pictures A to D would you like to eat? We have here a dessert. What do you think is this? ¿Qué creen que sea esto? What do you think is this? What do you think is this? And what do you think is this? And Which would you like to eat? ¿Cuál te gustaría comer? Now, can you make any dishes like this? ¿Puedes hacer un platillo así? And which is the most similar? ¿Cuál sería el más similar que pudieran hacer? And who does most of the cooking in your house? You or another person? ¿Quién hace la mayor parte de la cocina en your house? You or another person and why? Maybe your mother, maybe your grandmother, maybe your wife, or maybe you. Okay, now we continue. Four people talk about cooking. Listen and underline the correct answers. You're going to listen to Jake, Rosie, Joanna, and Toby. Do they talk about... ¿Sobre quién hablan? Himself, él mismo, or his wife. Y ya dependiendo sobre quién hable, vamos a ver si es a good cook or about cook. Y sobre qué platillo están hablando. Picture A, B, C, or D. Ok, ready?
Track 2.25. Jake.
I'm really bad at cooking. I eat lots of fast food and ready meals. I'm okay at making pasta, usually spaghetti with sauce. The one sauce I make is tomato and mushroom. It's not very good, but I like it. So I eat a lot of pasta because it's easy to make.
Rosie.
My husband's a great cook and he does all the cooking at home. He can look in our fridge and find some vegetables and cheese and then make a dish from it that's wonderful to eat, like vegetable moussaka. I don't know how he does it, but I'm lucky to have a husband like that.
Johanna.
My friends say I'm a good cook. I'm not sure, but I enjoy cooking, and if you enjoy something, you're often good at it. I think it's fun to try new dishes, and I certainly like eating the things I make. Tonight, I want to try a new fish dish. First, you grill the fish, then you make a lemon sauce. I think it'll go well with the bean salad I often make.
Toby.
My mother is a fantastic cook. But isn't everyone's mother a fantastic cook? I eat everything she makes, and I always want more. I really, really like the cookies she makes. My favorite is her pear cake. I love eating it warm with chocolate sauce.
Okay, if you want, you can listen it again. Si quieren, puedes volverlo a escuchar. Let's check. Jake. He talks about... himself, he is a bad cook, and he always makes spaghetti. Now Rosie, she talks about her husband, he's a good cook, and he cooks moussaka. Now Johanna, she talks about herself, she thinks it's a good cook, and she is going to try fish. Now Toby, he talks about his mother, she's a good cook, and he likes the pear cake. Now listen again, vuelvan a escuchar, listen again and answer the questions. Who always wants to eat more? Who can only make one thing? Who doesn't understand how you can make a really good dish from only a few things? No entiende cómo puedes hacer algo muy bueno de pocas cosas. Number four, who enjoys their own food? Let's check. Toby, he always wants to eat more. Jake, he only makes one thing. He always makes spaghetti. Rosie doesn't understand how her husband can make a really good dish from only a few things. And Johanna enjoys her own food, su propia comida. Now, think of someone you know who is a good cook. Piensa en alguien que sepas que es un buen cocinero. And make note, who, why is he or she a good cook? And what dishes does he or she make? Who do you know who is a good cook? My father, he is a great cook. Okay. So now let's check the part of reading. So now read Jake cooks. Who is it for? ¿Para quién es? Who is it for? People who know how to cook very well. Personas que ya saben cocinar very well. O people who want to learn how to cook, quieren aprender cómo cocinar. We have Jake cooks. Hi everyone, and welcome to my cooking blog. I'm not a good cook, but I want to become better. Quiero mejorar. I want to become better. I just want to learn how to cook simple dishes and eat well. I don't want to cook difficult things, and I don't want to be a famous chef. In this vlog, I want to tell you about the help I get from my family and friends and the things I try out. So, if you want to be a better cook, but not a chef, then maybe I can help you. So, who is it for? People who know how to cook very well, or people who want to learn how to cook? It's for people who want to learn how to cook. Now we continue. Read my food share. Mi comida compartida. My food share. What does Jake talk about? The food he eats or planning a dinner? My food shirt. Do you like the idea of cooking dinner for friends? Here are my ideas for planning a dinner for friends. I hope you find them useful. First, think about how many people you want to invite. Don't invite too many. I think 4 people is a good number. Next, ring, aquí sería como call or phone, ring or email to invite your friends and all agree on a night that's good for everyone. Que todos estén de acuerdo en una noche que sea buena para todos. After that, decide on your menu. Only choose food that you know how to prepare. Don't choose new and difficult dishes. It's just too hard. Your friends know that you are not a chef and your house is not a restaurant. Finally, on the day of the dinner, you need a lot of time to prepare everything, the food and the table. The weekend is good because you have all day to prepare. If everything is ready before your guests arrive, you can enjoy the dinner much more. Cooking for friends can be easy and fun. I hope it is for you. Before your guests arrive, las personas que invitas, the people who you invite, those are your guests. Okay, so what does Jake talk about? The food he eats or planning a dinner? It's about planning a dinner. Now read my food shirt again. Are the sentences true or false? And correct the false sentences. Number one, Jake hopes the blog can help other people plan a dinner for friends. Number two, it's not a good idea to invite a lot of people for dinner. Number three, it's always fun to try a new dish because friends can tell you if it's good or not. Decide the night of the dinner and tell your friends. It helps to do all the cooking before your friends come. Okay, so read it again. Are the sentences true or false? And correct the false sentences. Number one, it's true. Number two, it's true. Number three, it's false. It's too hard to try new dishes. You are not a chef and your house is not a restaurant. Four, false. Ring or email to invite your friends and all agree on a night that's good for everyone. And five is true. Now, do you prefer making meals for other people or going to someone's home for a meal? And why? What do you prefer? ¿Qué es lo que prefieren? ¿Ser el anfitrión o ser el invitado? Now we continue writing skills, making the order clear. In Jake's blog, the words first and next help make the order clear. First y next nos ayudan a establecer el orden. Underline two more phrases in the blog that also make the order clear. Tenemos first y next. ¿Qué otras dos frases o palabras nos ayudan a establecer un orden? After that and finally. Answer the questions. Which two phrases can we change with then? De estas, ¿cuál es similar a then? And what punctuation, signo de puntuación, do we use after these phrases? ¿Qué signo de puntuación utilizamos después de las frases? Okay, so we can change next and after that with then. And what punctuation do we use? We use a comma after these phrases. So, we have first. Tenemos next. Podemos tener then. We can have after that. And we can have finally. Esta y esta son las únicas que se van a mantener en su lugar. Obviamente tenemos first como lo primero y finally como lo último. Finalmente, estas podemos cambiarlas. Podemos tener next aquí, podemos tener after that aquí. Sin embargo, este sería el orden más común. Pero estos tres los pueden cambiar mientras se mantengan en el en estas posiciones. Ok. Now read the recipe for a bean salad. Only sentences 1 and 5 are in the correct order. Put the other sentences in the correct order. We have this. Cook the beans in hot water with a little salt. This is the first and this is the last. Place the bean salad in a nice bowl and serve to your guest. What is number 2? Which is number 3? And which is number 4? Okay. So, let's check. See answers in 3D below for the correct order. Okay. Una vez que ya tengan esto, los números, add the words in the box to the sentences in 3C. Tenemos las palabras que hemos conocido aquí. First, after that, next, then, y finally. Las van a tener que ubicar con estas. For example, here, number one, we use first. First, cook the beans in hot water. Luego, ¿cuál pudiéramos utilizar para el número 2, número 3, número 4 y número 5? ¿Cuál utilizamos con número 5? Ok, first, cook the beans in hot water with a little salt. One. Two. Pueden utilizar cualquiera de estas. Next, leave the beans until they are warm. Hasta que estén tibios. Then put lemon and oil on the warm bits, not too much. For after that, add salt and pepper and mix everything together. And finally, place the bean salad in a nice bowl and serve your guests. Now writing. Plan a blog about something you know how to do. What are good ideas to become better? And what's a good order to do things? Algo que sepan hacer, you know how to do. What are good ideas to become better, para ser mejor? Algunas ideas para mejorar, para ser mejor en lo que ya eres bueno. And what's a good order to do the things? Write your blog. Use my food share to help you. Okay, for example. Soy bueno al tocar la guitarra. If you want to become better at playing guitar, this is a blog for you. First, ¿y qué es lo que pueden hacer para empezar a tocar la guitarra? Ajá, este sería mi ejemplo. First, learn all the chords. Aprende todos los acordes. Next. Esos son algunos pasos que pudieran seguir. Pueden utilizar esto como ejemplo para hacer your own blog, su propio blog. En algo que sean buenos, recuérdenlo, algo que sepan hacer. Maybe cooking, dancing, playing an instrument, singing, riding a bike. Now we continue unit 4, review and extension. Correct the words 1 to 10 that are wrong, las que estén equivocadas. There's a very good market near my home. I always go there to buy food. ¿Es esta correcta o está incorrecta? Some stall sells vegetables. ¿Está correcta o incorrecta? And fruits. ¿Correcta o incorrecta? Y las que estén incorrectas las van a tener que corregir. Correct the words that are wrong. Now underline the correct answers. Have we got an or any? How much or many coffee do you drink? Next, choose the correct answer. I haven't got some, many, or much. Vocabulary. Match the words in the box with 1 to 5. Then add one more to each group. Kinds of meat. ¿Cuál de estas is a kinds of meat? And then add one more word to each group. Van a tener que añadir otra más aparte de las que tenemos aquí. Look at 1 to 9, which are normal, a tick, and which are unusual or impossible. For example, grilled chicken, pollo a la parrilla, grilled chicken, that is normal. Roast butter, that is impossible, es imposible. Now we continue word power like. First, think what like means. Piensen lo que significa like. Now read the three conversations with which one matches the picture. ¿Cuál de estas conversaciones se relaciona con la imagen? What fruit do you like? I like most kinds of fruit, but not bananas. Number 2. What vegetables would you like? I'd like potatoes and carrots, please. We want to have a party. Would you like to join us? Yes, thanks. I'd love to. Okay, it's conversation two. What vegetables would you like? Now, as you can see, we have three different kinds of questions. Look at the questions in 3A. Which question is about what B wants now? ¿Cuál de todas es la que B, la persona B, quiere justamente ahora? Which question invites B to go somewhere? ¿Cuál de estas es una invitación? And which question is about what B likes in general, not just now? Como pueden ver, aquí tenemos la diferencia de la 1 y la 3. Que la 1 es sobre ahora, now. And 3 is about like in general, el gusto en general. Okay, so number one, what vegetables would you like? Es sobre what vegetables would you like? Entonces estamos utilizando el would you like para preguntar sobre lo que se quiere ahora. ¿Qué vegetales te gustarían? What vegetables would you like? In vegetables somewhere. Would you like to join us? Pueden crear lo que sigue aquí. Would you like to go to a party? ¿Te gustaría una fiesta? Would you like to go for a walk? Ir a una caminata. Would you like to go to the cinema? Pero este, el de would you like, nos está ayudando para hacer invitaciones. ¿Ok? Now, what fruit do you like? Do you like es en presente simple, le estamos hablando sobre gustos en general, no solamente ahora. Está preguntando qué fruta le gusta en general. What fruit do you like? What music do you like? ¿Qué música te gusta? What films do you like? ¿Qué películas te gustan? Sin embargo, aquí, si utilizáramos what film would you like to see, ¿qué película te gustaría ver? Entonces, ahí estaríamos haciendo lo que es ahora. Ok, match A to C with similar meanings in 1, 2, 3, in B. Here we have I don't like. ¿Qué es lo que significa? Would you like to come to my birthday party? And I'd like two lemons, please. Let's check. Number one, I don't like Big Brother. Gustos en general no le gusta. Okay. Two would be, would you like, invitar, would you like to come to my party, party? And one is about what Big wants to know. One, what Big wants now. Como se podrán acordar, utilizamos el de I'd like para pedir algo. I'd like two lemons, I'd like a chicken salad, I'd like a sandwich, I'd like some water. Sin embargo, estamos haciendo de referencia que es lo que queremos en el momento. Match the marked words in 1 to 4 with meanings A to D. Tenemos aquí, what is it like? Like that, like. Van a tener que encontrar cuál es el correcto significado. Si quieren, pueden cambiarlas, pueden posicionarlos. ¿Cuál sería mejor? Por ejemplo, aquí. The same as to live without the internet. For example, to live without the internet. How is it to live without the internet? In that way, to live without the internet. ¿Cuál es el que se ajusta más? Lo mismo con estas. Ok, so let's check. Number one, how is it? Te está preguntando la manera. ¿Cómo es? What is it like? How is it to live without the internet? They haven't got a computer. I couldn't live in that way. No pudiera vivir así, de esa manera. I couldn't live like that, in that way. B, I eat a lot of fruit. For example, apple, pears, melons and bananas. Serían como sinónimos. Otra manera de decirlo. For example, apples, like apples. She's 20 and she studies Russian just the same as me. Justo como yo. Just like me. Entonces, aquí ya diferiría mucho del significado general que conocen de like. Ya no sería sobre gustos, sino más bien de comparaciones. Por ejemplo, aquí estamos comparando la manera. Aquí estamos poniendo ejemplos. Aquí estamos comparando a las personas. Just like me. Now here, write a question with like for each situation. Invite a friend to the cinema on Friday. ¿Cómo pudieran invitar a un amigo? Con algunas de estas preguntas. You are in a shop. Ask for some apples. ¿Quieres algunas manzanas? Entonces tienes que utilizar una frase con like. You are a waiter in a café. A customer says a coffee, please. Estás en un... Tú eres un mesero. Y un mesero dice a coffee, please. Someone is a guest in your home. You want to know what to cook for him or her. ¿Quieres saber qué cocinar? At a party, someone say he or she lives in New York. Ask him about the city. Pregúntale cómo es la ciudad. Aquí podrías utilizar una de estas. Ok. These are suggested answers. Sugerencias. Ok. For number one, would you like to come? Would you like invitación? Would you like to come to the cinema on Friday? I'd like some apples. Para pedir lo que quieres justo ahora. What you want right now. Would you like black or white coffee? ¿Te gustaría café o negro? Would you like some sugar? ¿Le gustaría algo de azúcar? Entonces, ¿cómo le gustaría su café? What would you like for lunch? For dinner, ¿qué te gustaría para cenar o para comer? What would you like for dinner? What's New York like? Entonces aquí lo que estamos utilizando es el verbo to be y el like. Y en medio lo que vamos a estar comparando. Básicamente el what's like significa cómo es, pero haciendo referencia a el sentido de cómo es vivir ahí. What's New York like? Ok. Ask and answer the questions in 3A with a partner. And we are finished. Review your progress. How well did you do in this unit? Now, what can you do? ¿Qué es lo que puedes hacer? And how well can you do it? ¿Qué también lo puedes hacer? Ok. We have 3 for very well, 2 for well, and 1 not so well, and that's everything.